I'm gonna bake my mom's signature cranberry pie. I love it. It's a really unusual way to use cranberries. They're so beautiful, they're vibrant. So I wanna make a pie crust that really does them justice and brings that tang to the forefront. So I start with 5 cups of all-purpose flour, and to that I add 2 teaspoons of salt and 2 teaspoons of granulated sugar. That's the dry foundation for my pie crust. So once I get the flour, sugar, and salt together, then we add in the shortening. Now listen, I hear you on the shortening because you're thinking, use butter. I like to use shortening here because I think it has a more neutral flavor than butter does. I don't want that buttery taste in the crust. I actually want that buttery taste to come out in the filling. So I just add 2 cups of shortening in here and I just start working it in. And I start with the spatula, just kind of pressing the shortening into the dough. So you can see it changing texture. You can see the flour forming those little pea-shaped balls you often read about in cookbooks and recipes. So then I start working it in with my hands a little bit. It's definitely more effective, but the heat from my hands is something that puts a time limit on this. Okay, now, I'm gonna measure out 2/3 of a cup of ice water, and then I just pour that ice water right in here. And you see that ice water really changes the dough and it really comes together. Now that we've made the pie crust, I wanna chill it down a little bit. And I'll do that by dividing it into 2 equal parts. And pressing it down into some plastic wrap and chilling it up in the fridge. So at this point, you can actually save yourself a lot of grief if you just press your dough out a little bit into this little plastic package, because it's as if most of the rolling has been done already. So I'll just make my little pie crust sandwich, top, bottom, into the fridge to take a little nap. So once the pie crust is knocked out of the way, let's face it, the really fun part about making a pie is getting the filling together. Cranberries are really tart, so I always like to add a little bit of another fruit to kind of round it out. If we have a few slices of Anjou pear, it's just gonna add richness to the texture of the fruit filling. For this pie, I find that a slightly underripe pear is actually better. And that makes buying a little easier because you don't have so much pressure to buy it perfect. Cut the pears into slices. And since they're gonna cook a little bit, don't worry so much about them being perfectly thin. Stay between, say, 1/4 and 1/2 inch in thickness. So for my pie filling, to create a little contrast, I'm gonna use butter. So I start by just melting 1 tablespoon or so. I add those pears in. Give them a little toss just to coat them with the butter. So once the pears start to melt down a little bit in the butter, just give them a minute, and then we're gonna start adding in those little Thanksgiving-y touches. I'll start with 1 tablespoon of corn syrup, 3 whole cloves, a little bit of orange zest right over the top, the equivalent of about 1 tablespoon. But the heart of this pie actually lives with the cranberries. 1 more tablespoon of butter. I just wanna toss the cranberries, get a little of the liquid out of them, soften them slightly before I mix them with everything and put them in the pie. So I just drop 24 ounces of cranberries. Look at how beautiful that is. Now the cranberries are tart, and to bring that out to the foreground even more, a squeeze of lemon juice. And then because we added lemon juice to a really tart fruit, I will add 1/2 cup of regular sugar. Now it's time to put these 2 halves together. The pear with the orange zest and the cloves, the real aromas of Thanksgiving. And then the main ingredient, the cranberries. And you can see just from cooking them for 1 minute with the sugar, see all that pectin coming out? That wonderful, thick, kind of jammy liquid? That's the stuff pies are made of. Mmm. My head gets lower and lower and closer to the bowl as I stir. And just to make sure that this pie comes together, I'll add in 1 tablespoon of cornstarch. I'll just strain it over the top. So now that this pie filling is really coming together, I'll let it cool so we can start building our pie. Okay, so I'm building the pie now. Now after the pie crust has chilled down a little bit in my fridge, that's when I roll out the bottom and the top, the 2 layers, and I start building this delicious pie. Now, because the cranberry filling has a decent amount of liquid in it, I'm not gonna prick or dock the dough on the bottom at all. I'll leave it intact. So once this is rolled to a similar thickness as the bottom, I do the same thing I did with it, and I just roll it up on the pin, give the filling a nice stir, and start loading it up. And then we bring this Thanksgiving pie home by tucking it into the little crust bed. You see that wonderful little crevice right there? That's what pie is all about. I like to keep the crust nice and thick, because I love when I cut a piece of pie and the crust is kind of poking up a little bit. And then we cut our little window into the soul of the pie. So I do it just the way my mom did it. I cut an X in the center and just open up these little windows. So I'll put this pie in the fridge. Let's get that pie that's been napping so gently in the fridge into the oven. So I start this pie off at a very high temperature, 425 degrees. I'll cook it for about 10 minutes, and then we'll start lowering the temperature gradually. So for the finishing touch, just cover the top of this with granulated sugar.